Previously on QualiaZ.
ChatGPT is making us dumber.
Surely we can trust it, right? We can trust the answer.
Identify the gaps, focus on those gaps because that's where the future is.
You're not using it to help you get the answers to your homework, you're using it to help you broaden your knowledge.
In a recent update, ChatGPT announced the ability to turn your personal pictures into Studio Ghibli's art style. With this, the internet was then flooded with a bunch of personal pictures and some memes. But it also came with immense backlash from everyone. With AI getting more and more advanced at generating art and images, it begs the question, man versus AI, who is more creative? You're watching QualiaZ, and this is AI for Dummies. Before jumping into action, think about this first. What does it mean to be creative? In most basic definition, it's all about the act of creating something new. But is that enough? Philosophers and researchers have tried to separate creativity into different aspects. Things like surprising, spontaneous, it needs to have a creator, and originality. We have seen many people being surprised by AI's ability to create images and artwork. And upon being prompted, it can also give you several options for you to pick from. Sure, its ability is surprising and amazing and all, but can it create something original, something brand new? Or all it does is copy humans' work? As a matter of fact, how does generative AI even work in the first place? In the last episode, we covered how AI chatbots learn from internet data to help it learn that loyalty and furry are associated with the word dogs. The same process happened here with generative AI, but it has to pair an image with a word so that it can learn abstraction to recognize what is and is not a dog. If we learn how to draw by picking up a pen and start drawing, how does an AI learn? There are multiple ways we can approach generating an image, but let's just start with diffusion. In the first stage, take this picture of a dog. The AI will step by step sprinkle some noise onto the image until it becomes unrecognizable, until it becomes a messy palette of noise. When it reaches this stage, the goal is to simply reverse the damage. But here's the thing, it's not about cleaning up, because it has to tap into its abstraction to strategically remove the noise according to what it knows about the subject. For example, if the prompt includes a picture of a dog, it will have to recognize the features necessary to make this image, things like boba eyes, furry, four legs, has a snout, and so on. And after a bunch of steps, the AI will reach the final layer, removing the final bits of noise, and then we get... Wait a minute. This isn't the same dog. This happens because of randomness. At every stage of noise reduction, AI can make different decisions, and this difference over time will lead to a completely different image. So this explains two things. First, this is why AI struggles so much with consistency. Producing two identical images is really hard. But more importantly, if we look at it this way, all AI is doing is slowly removing the noises, reorganizing pixels to get an image. So technically, it's not copying, and some could say that it's just a misunderstood artist with its own creative sense. Nothing wrong with that, right?
Are you sure about that?
AI may not be copying from us, but the data it learned from on the internet is ours, and most of the time, it doesn't have consent. And more importantly, since it learns so much from us, sometimes by pure coincidence or by algorithm, the output resembles our work. For example, if I type in this prompt, red plumber man jumping, the AI will generate some variation of the character Mario. But notice how I never explicitly ask for Mario in my prompt. Why does it still choose to steer towards this character and not make a new one? Let's try another experiment. I will show you two images and you will have to tell me which one is AI generated. If you chose the left one, you would be correct. That is AI generated. But if you pick the right image, you would also be correct, because unfortunately, both of these are AI generated. This is why the community is protesting. Not only do they have to protect their job facing the competition that is rising in thousands, but most importantly, they have to protect what is core to us human beings. Their uniqueness, our uniqueness. It is the core to our decision every day. What we do, what we believe in, what we think. And to really understand why this is so important, let's hear it from the experts.
In psychology, it's usually not only about something that is new, but something that is, in a sense, appropriate or fit for a certain context. So it is new and it functions within a particular system. On the other hand, some philosophers like to think of creativity as an act of genius or an inspiration that is almost impossible to explain. So it's something very subjective and almost magical. So if I give you an example, do you speak like your parents speak?
I speak the same language.
You use exactly the same words, the same phrases, the same sounds?
Perhaps not 100%.
Not 100%. So every generation does some changes to the language. Every region, every village, every city does some changes to language. Nobody's telling us to make those changes. It doesn't work like that. It happens. And one of the things that many linguists agree on is that that is because there is an inherent creativity in language use that humans constantly perform without even knowing that they do that.
Artificial intelligence is getting better, but it is also bringing so much more uncertainties. Where do we even draw the line between human inspiration and AI learning to be creative?
If you think about contemporary art, it's technically not difficult. Most of it, it's not difficult, but it comes from a societal context, from a time period where, as a society, we agree this is art, this is novel, this is creative, we treat it as art. It can follow the same, right? So if, as a society, we agree this, whatever is created by AI models, is valuable, unique, it fits into the context, societal context, then that would be creative, wouldn't it be? There's so many artists, you could ask them to paint a picture in the style of, let's say, Picasso, and they will do a fantastic job, but it will not become a Picasso painting. And if we know that this is a fake, a counterfeit picture that is not by Picasso, we would immediately devalue it as a human product. And I think that's the same principle of ethicality. The AI models, with the big difference, is that we don't know what data the models have been trained on. In music and art, we have intellectual property rights. And I think this is kind of like how we humans decided to structure society to deal with these kinds of problems. And clearly something like this will be necessary for AI creations as well.
With that being said, is AI actually destroying creativity and replacing all of us? Is there a future where both AI and human can work together creatively? Before heading to the future, let us look at the past. In the 19th century, the introduction of photography challenged the role of artists, more specifically portrait artists, but in reality, they found a new job. Since the photos were black and white, the painters gave it life by adding their touches, giving it better and more saturated colors. Then came the 1980s. CGI back then was all about stop motion, and it needed animators like Phil Tippett to make things come alive. But when a demo of realistic computer graphic dinosaur was shown, he says,
"And it blew my mind again. And I turned to Phil, and Phil looked at me, and Phil said, he said, I think I'm extinct."
But that was not the case, because with his expertise, he was invited by Steven Spielberg to oversee the animation of these dinosaurs, which eventually led to an Oscar in visual effects for Jurassic Parks. How about the modern day? The director James Cameron expressed that he is cautiously optimistic. He thinks that AI can help us spend time more efficiently, meaning less time spending on the technicality like rendering, and more time focused on our creative vision. But that is just the beginning. History has shown us that new technology can open up vast possibilities. The question is, what does AI open up for us?
I think Newton is a very good example, because often when people talk about creativity or when they talk about genius, then they have this image of Newton taking a nap under like an apple tree, then the apple falls and he comes up with the idea of gravity, right? That's not how creativity works in reality. It's not that an apple falls down and any random person then has this creative insight. It's quite well established that for creativity, we need expertise. The same goes with very successful entrepreneurs. It's not that they just out of the blue, they come up with an idea to solve a problem, but they have the necessary background knowledge and expertise to create a solution that's novel and that solves a problem.
Okay, look, artificial intelligence is here to stay, whether we like it or not. It's bringing so much uncertainty and risk into our lives, but just maybe it's a blessing in disguise, because it is in times like these where we really do have the chance to reflect, to really ask ourselves what it means to be creative and unique. Because in the past, new technology emerged, things like photography, painting, digital art, computer graphics. It begged questions. It made us worried for an amount of time, but then we overcame it. We redefined what it meant to be creative. We found new ways to adapt to new technology. And I don't think that core energy would ever change, whether it is now with AI or new technology in the future. Our desire to create, to be creative, that is the one thing that I don't think will ever change.
Let's say in the mid-1980s, working on practical effects, and they made movies, you would probably have a few dozen people that were on a crew that were in charge of the practical effects. Now, again, look at the credits in a Marvel movie. You're talking about hundreds and hundreds of jobs, people, jobs spread around the world, all based around using digital technology for computer graphics. A few years ago, I was asked by my team to try to find two or three really great headlines for an ad campaign that we're doing. And this is when ChatGPT first came out, and I was like, okay, I'm gonna really test this to sort of see what it can do. And eventually I had a list of about 30 different possible headlines for an ad that we were gonna use on LinkedIn. And I had those, and what I did is I put in about three or four that I had written myself. We went around the table as a team, we talked about it, and we voted on it, right? And every single person around the table chose something that was human made, as opposed to AI made. We're not gonna land on very easy answers today, I'm sorry, but we're just gonna pose these questions, generating the discussions that we need. And by doing this, that's how we come to these consensus. What is art? What is not art? What is creative? What is not creative, right?
It's the same advice that I try to give to my son, whether he listens to me or not. And that is, the best thing that you can do is to learn as much about it to the point that you think not only you understand it, but that you can control it. The best way to be on top of anything is to understand it and who knows to know how to control it. Then you might decide that all you want to do is be a painter of old-fashioned, whatever technique. That's fine. But take the time to understand what happens, know how you can work with it or work without it, and at the point you're free to do what you want.
We have just explored how AI, for better or worse, is impacting the creative industry. But if we zoom out a little, we will see that it is impacting everything around us, including the economy. It is changing the way we work, and it is showing up new possibilities that previously unheard of. In our next episode, we will discover how AI is changing the market, how it is changing business world, and funnily enough, how to get rich with AI. Take things with a grain of salt, always challenge the status quo. Catch you next time.